the welfare state, socialism and welfareism, it does the opposite because it consumes. Governments produce nothing. All they can do is take from one and give to another. And you know, it's always done with good intention. We're going to take care of the poor. But what do they do? Who ends up with all the loot? The wealthy ends up with the loot, and the poor get poorer, and the middle class gets wiped out. But we can't continue to be fooled in this manner. We have to realize that there is a better way of doing this. And when the government takes it over and they take control of the means of wealth and they tax us to the hilt and they control our money and undermine the system and we become less productive, what do we have? We have more aggressive people going to Washington on a daily basis. The special interest grows, the lobbying grows, and there's nothing left. And this is what's happening. Our pie is shrinking and also our freedoms are shrinking. But I am very, very confident. You know, in spite of all these problems we talk about, I am absolutely convinced if we are able to maintain our liberties, even if we have a downturn, even if we have to pay back some of these debt that we have incurred, what we need then is just to go back to work. And believe me, we'll be back on our feet in a very short time. This to a large degree, is put the puzzle back together. About 100 years ago or so, for some reason we got off track and we started talking about freedom. We talked about personal freedom and economic freedom as if they were two different things. But they're not two different things. It's our lives that we want, and we want the fruits of our labor. They're all in the one. But here we have some who are called liberals, generally are supposed to protect our civil liberties and our personal privacy and things. Sometimes they don't do a very good job either. But on the other hand, economic conservatives are supposed to protect our personal economic liberties. And yet they don't do a very good job either. But the whole thing is, it's all one piece. We are important because we are individuals. We are important because our rights come to us in a natural way. I happen to believe they come to us from our Creator. We should always be seen as individuals as being very, very important. If we're seen as only as a person in a group, and if we try to get benefits because we belong to a group, believe me, if you're in that particular group, you can lose them because you belong to a group. And that's where some of our problems have been over a couple hundred years now, because we design people in groups. Matter of fact, there's one thing that happens in the campaign that maybe it doesn't bother anybody else, but it sort of bothers me when the media gets involved and they do all this polling, and they always say, well, how did the Hispanics vote? How did the blacks vote? How did the whites vote? Why don't we ask, how did the Americans vote? So we don't know exactly what will happen on Tuesday, next week, next month, or tomorrow. I don't work on the operation that I know exactly what happens in the future. But I do make assessments. I do know that if we are not successful, short term or long term, the future is bleak for the United States. But I am encouraged. I am encouraged by this campaign and the enthusiasm. So no matter what happens on a particular election or a particular day, what we must do as a group, now that we have been exposed to these views and we're enthusiastic that we have once again come together and we have discovered that we have allies, we must stick together and make sure that this movement continues and that till the point where we're still freedom.